Well, we do have that pinpoint weather alert for you this morning. Get ready to crank up the AC if you've got it, or find somewhere to go. Heat is on the way. For the first time in almost a year, there is a heat watch listed for the Portland area. So we've got some team coverage for you this morning. Brent Weisberg standing by. He's got a look at the information on how to beat the heat and where to go. But first, let's turn to Sally Shulman. She's taking a look at those rising temperatures and exactly what we can expect for this weekend. I guess it depends on where you live, right, Sally?
It does. I think I can pretty much guarantee that most of us are going to see 95 to 100 degree temperatures by Saturday. But let me walk through what I'm forecasting for Portland, the Portland metro area, 87 degrees today. So that's a good 10 degrees warmer than yesterday under plenty of sunshine. The clouds are already starting to break up outside. 96 degrees on Saturday. Can you believe that? 96 and then 92 on Sunday. Average this time of year is 82 degrees. The record, in case you're wondering, on Saturday is more than 100 degrees. And so I don't think we're going to break that, but hot nonetheless. And that's the reason the National Weather Service has issued an excessive heat watch for the Portland metro area Saturday and Saturday evening, which will be the hottest period of time in this little heat stretch, you know, or hot heat wave. But I think just about everybody through the Willamette Valley, from the coast all the way to the Cascade foothills and through the gorge, will be between 95 and 100 degrees. Coming up in just a little bit, I've got your weekend forecast. It's very hot, including the events, big huge events this weekend, the Oregon Jamboree and the Air Show. How's the weather going to be for those? I'll let you know in a minute.
Lots of water and sunscreen for those folks. All right, Sally, thank you very much. Well, as you just heard, we could creep toward the century mark this weekend. So how do you stay cool? Where do you go? What's open? Well, let's turn to Coin Local 6 reporter Brent Weisberg. He's got some information for us, and he's already out there enjoying the mild temperatures this morning. Hi, Brent.
Good morning, you guys. As Sally just said, these clouds are going to burn off. One of the things you really need to have this weekend, water. It's going to help you stay hydrated, and firefighters say it will help fend off any heat-related issues. But firefighters also say take it easy when staying hydrated, because you can also hurt yourself if you overhydrate. Now, hospitals across the metro are getting ready for more heat-related injuries over the next few days. People who suffer from breathing problems should take it easy. It's also a good reminder to check on your neighbors, especially if they have a hard time moving around. We also can't stress enough the importance of wearing sunscreen. The UV index the next couple of days will be dangerously high, meaning it will only take a matter of minutes before you could burn. If you plan to head out on the river or area lakes, it is another reminder mixing sun and booze could have deadly consequences.
Drinking a lot of water is huge. Not drinking the sodas, things like that, but drinking the water.
For your home, experts say open up the windows right now in the early morning to bring in that cool air. But firefighters remind you, if you do have small kids, make sure that they are kept away from the window. That way they will not fall out. A story we have been telling you that has happened very often this summer and spring. They also say leaving your fans running all day could actually cause your apartment to get warmer, or even your home to get warmer. And they say that electricity bill will also go up. We have some more reminders on our website at coinlocal6.com that will help you beat the heat this weekend. Reporting for you live this morning, I'm Brent Weisberg, Coin Local 6.
All right, Brent, thank you very much. Well, another cooling off option may return just in the nick of time for Clark County residents to beat the heat. According to the Columbian, Clineline Pond could reopen to swimmers by tomorrow. Now, the pond, as you probably recall, was closed last week after high amounts of bacteria were found in the water, but officials say tests from Monday show the bacteria level has dropped back into the safe zone. Officials expected to make a final decision on reopening the pond later today.